Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this video, we're going to talk about the dangers of using prednisone. Now, what is prednisone? It's a synthetic version of cortisol, okay? And it's used for rheumatoid arthritis, inflammatory conditions, autoimmune diseases, a lot of skin issues. It's used for a lot of different things, and I believe it's one of the most abused drugs on the market. It's been given out too much. It has some serious side effects. So if you are caught up in this where you've taken too much, this video is for you, okay? Because this is what it can do. It totally destroys your muscles. It wastes your muscles, inactivates your adrenal glands. It creates more inflammation once you stop taking it. It can trigger diabetes. I know of a guy who took it and for Bell's palsy, which is a condition of the nerve root on the face, and boom, he gets diabetes. Lowered immune system, so then you're getting sick more often, insomnia, cataracts, hip fractures, liver damage, shrinking testes, decreased libido, and more belly fat. Yeah, that's a lot of issues. So from my viewpoint, it's in a situation where once you start taking it, all of a sudden you're going to need more and more of it because the adrenals aren't strong enough. See, a little bit of cortisone is good for your body, if your body makes it, if it's normal. But what happens when you run out of it, you start getting a lot of symptoms, and then all of a sudden now you need more of this. So you really have to build back up the adrenals. So there is three things I know that can help support that. Number one, to support the actual adrenal gland itself. This is called cortisol support. This is mainly to work on people with low adrenals, okay? Low cortisol. It's like a burnt out adrenal, and it has adrenal extracts and liver support and natural vitamin C to bring back the adrenal back up. So this is a great transition thing to, as you're coming off prednisone, and also to take it to kind of build up your adrenals. It's not a long-term product. It's mainly for 3 months. Now, also you want to take something called NAC. It's called N-acetylcysteine. What the heck is that? That is something that it will increase something called glutathione. What's glutathione? Well, it's one of the most powerful antioxidants that you have that will kind of lessen the damage. It kind of buffers the damage from this and from even like Tylenol. So it's a really good kind of a detoxifier, an organ protector. It's great to take if you have cataracts. I mean, anyone who's cataracts needs to take this right here. There's not a lot of side effects, and you can get it from Amazon.com. So this is something that's really good to help repair the damage. And also stinging nettle root. Okay, this is one of my favorite anti-inflammatory herbs. You can take this too, because without good adrenals, you tend to have more inflammation. This will help that tremendously. So those are the three things that I would do. Now, as far as your eating goes, there's a couple things that are going to be essential to put in your salad. And you need a lot of vegetables as well to start supporting these adrenals. Dandelion tops and also beet tops. Those are the two top things that I would recommend if you want to start kind of repairing some of the damage. It's great for the liver. It's really good for inflammation. Good for a lot of other things. Okay? So apply this information and put your comments below.